Hello students, welcome to e-learning. Today we are going to start with our fourth lecture in the chapter 4 supply. Now that is first topic is supply function and the second topic is law of supply. So these are the two topics which we are going to cover today in this lecture. Now let's start with first, that is supply function. Now here supply function is nothing but it is a mathematical expression or representation of relation of supply of a goods with its determinants. Now determinants we have already studied in our first lecture, that is we can say price of a product, then after level of technology, then after we find factor of production, or we can say cost of production, then after we find like expectation regarding future prices and the other factors. So this all different determinants of how it has been affecting or how there is a relationship with the supply function, that has been known and that has been written in a mathematical equation form. So let us see that particular. So here you find that Sx is equals to F, that is F of Px plus T plus Pf plus Pe plus Pu, or we can say this all factors include together, it becomes supply function. Now let's see what is mean. Now Sx means supply of X commodity or X product. Then after F is a functional notation, then comes Px, that is price of commodity X, and less, then after you find the T, that is level of technology, and then after you find PF, that is factor prices. It is also known as cost of production prices, or we can say factor of production. So all that particular four factor of production, that is known as factor prices. Now then comes expectation regarding future prices. All this particular determinants we have already studied in our first video. So this is been expressed in the equation form. And lastly, that is U means other factors. So this is how you find that it is a mathematical expression, that all that factors affecting supply can be written in a mathematical equation form. I hope you have been clear. So that is just a mathematical representation, or we can say mathematical expression of this particular factors affecting demand and to the supply of a particular good. So let's go with the next one, that is we find that law of supply. Now what does the law of supply? In the beginning of a chapter only we have told you that there is, you find that it is same concept. If you want to, I mean you have already studied law of demand, so same way your law of supply will be there, but the concept is different, because you find that here the law states that when all the other factors affecting supply are assumed to be constant, that is means all these factors, or we can say determinants which we have studied, that all the price, we can say level of technology, future prices, factor of production, other we can say other factors, all these are been constant at particular time, and that time if any price increase of a product is been there, what will happen, the supply of that particular product also will increase. As and when, again suppose when the price of this particular product is decreasing, the supply also decrease, or we can say contract. So this is what the law of supply states. So you have to first remember that where all the factors affecting supply should be constant, and then after you find price increase, supply increase, price decrease, supply decrease. So it shows a positive relation between the supply of a good as well as the, we can say, price of the particular good. So this is called law of supply. So this relation is called law of supply. Now here again you find that we have to go with assumptions. Now what is assumption? To make a particular law successful, you need to have certain assumptions. Now assumptions here means some units or some particular point should be the we have to keep together, then only this particular law function should will work. So here law assumptions are, we can say, first is price of factor of production remain constant. So very first factor is the price of factor of production, or we can say cost of production should remain same, or we can say constant. It should not change when we are calculating or we are demonstrating law of supply. That time the any factor should not change for making of that particular product, that is cost of production. Second, you find that there should not be no change in the state of technology. Yes, when we are applying this law of supply, that time there should be no change in the technology anywhere. Then you find that level of competition remains the same. Yes, so here competition means different sellers in the market. So you are not the only one seller in the market, you are having different sellers also. So that particular level of competition should be the same. It should not increase, decrease, or the supply, we can say like there should not be the ample amount of sellers comes when you are measuring the law of supply, or there should be a decrease of sellers when you are doing this particular law of supply. So you find that all this particular seller should be the same as previously it was. Then you find that expectation regarding future prices are ignored, or we can say held constant. So you should not we can say judge, or you can just estimate that in future that particular price will fall or increase. So that particular thing should also not happen. And lastly, other factors like government policies, transport facility, natural facility, natural factors, disaster should not come. It should remain same. So when all these factors are constant or same, then only you find that our law of demand, law of supply can be working. Now let's just look about how it can be demonstrated. Now for demonstrating, we have taken a supply schedule. For that is here the table, you can observe here there is two columns are there: price of an apple, price of an apple per kg, which is in rupees, the first column, and the second column, that is you find that supply of apples in kgs. So here at rupees 50, 200 kgs of apples are supplied. But when the price increased from 50 to 60, the supply increased from 200 to 400. Again, same one, again the 10 rupees price is increased from 60 to 70. You find that from it increased from 400 to 600. Again, when a price increased from 70 to 80, it increased. So you find that as and when the price is increasing, the supply of the particular apples also are increasing. So the law of supply is working here again in this schedule. Now, again, to clear cut understanding, we are going to represent on a particular diagram. So here the diagram of supply curve we can know. So here on the x-axis you find the supply has been taken up. Here on the y-axis you find the price has been taken up. Now again the scale measures here, that is 2 cm equals to 200 kgs, whereas here the 1 cm equals to 10 rupees, which 10 rupees has been measured up here in this diagram on the y-axis. So now we need to plot this particular supply schedule on the curve. So here you find that at rupees 50 it is 200. So here on the y-axis 50, and here it is 200 on the supply side, that is on the x side. Then you find that at rupees 60 you find 400 is the thing. So again above 50 you find 60 has been there, and there point B has been placed where 400 is been there. So here different combinations points are being made, various points are being, and this particular points when it is been joined, it becomes SS, that is supply curve. So this particular line is been called supply curve, which shows that when there is an increase in price, you find that the demand also increases. So this is how law of supply has been working when all the other factors, main point, when all the other factors remain constant. Now let's go with the explanation. So what all things which we have observed? First, what should be there? First is the on the x-axis and on the y-axis, what you represent. So on the y-axis you are representing price of an apple, and on the x-axis you are representing supply of apple. Then comes the, we can say, graph. The graph shows the several points like A, B, C, D, E, which shows various combination of price and supply of apples. Then comes the at what price. So when price is 50, the supply is 200 kgs. When price is 60, you find that supply extends, or we can say increases to 400, from 200 to 400. Same way you find that, you find when price increase from 60 to 70, you find that the supply again increase to 600 from 400. So this is how you find that it goes on. Whenever there is an increase in price, the seller try to sell more at a higher price to attain more profit, and this is how the law of supply works. Now here you find that this combinations, as I told you, there are different points A, B, C, D. When this particular combination joins together, it becomes supply curve, that is known as SS. Now we observe there is a positive relation between the price of an apple and supply of an apple. So you find that this particular thing, law of supply, is very easy. It is directly positive relationship. You no need to remember any extra thing. If a price is increasing, yes, the supply is increasing. So you find that every increase in price gives every increase in the supply of that particular product. Here it is, take example is taken of apple. So this is what you find that law of supply is all about. The last point is, what is the relation between price and supply? So there are two reasons, or we can say two reasons for positive relation between the price and supply. That is, first, the seller pursues the objective of profit maximum. Yes, any seller who is there in the market does not want to sell at loss. So what his main objective is to earn more profit. So that time, what will happen, you find that when the price rises, he sees the possibility of increasing profit. Yes. So whenever there is an increase in price, he thinks that I will get the more profit if I sell at this particular price. So that time what he will do, he will supply more at that particular when the price are higher. Now the second point is there again, when price rises, those producers who are not willing to sell at their stock at lower prices. Now there are certain sellers who don't want to be much greedy, but they don't want to sell the particular product because that the price are lower, means compared to the normal price the price became lower. That time what will happen, many of the supplier or many of the seller will stop selling and wait for the time when the particular normal price comes, or we can say some higher prices come. So that time you find that those sellers also stop supplying their stock in the market, and again when the price rises, that time they try to sell the stock. So these are the two weak reasons where why you find that there is a positive relation between the price and the supply of that particular good, because they want to earn more profit and they don't want to go in losses. That time they try to stop supply that particular goods and they wait for the right time so that they can sell their products more and more. I hope you have been clear with these two topics today. That is, we find that supply function, that is a mathematical representation of all the determinants, or we can say factors affecting supply and the supply of a particular good, and you find that law of supply, which has a positive relationship between the price and the supply of the goods. I hope you have been clear. You need to write down the notes. I will be sending today PDF also. So if you find any difficulty, you can call or message me. Thank you.